9 barrels, so the gun's getting longer and there's more flex out there and stuff. So we need to make sure everybody's out of that red zone area. Nobody needs to be up there unless they absolutely need to. The other thing is the communication stuff you guys have got with us on the radio. We really appreciate it. You guys are keeping radios clear while we're pumping down stuff. Sometimes when we get down there, we're going to have to orient the guns a little bit, and we're going to have to pump back down a little bit and move the gun stretches because of the extra added weight. So if you guys can, make sure that you keep the radios clear. You may think that it's taking a little bit longer than normal and stuff, so we may have to be adjusting a few things while we're making the preparations. So just have a little bit of patience with us. I'll give you an all shots fired as soon as we get done. The wireline runs should start getting a little bit shorter as we get back closer to the curve. So if you need to, just a heads up in case you need to schedule your sand a little bit sooner and stuff, or your pump maintenance or whatever. I mean, the wireline runs should start getting a little bit shorter. So just a heads up on that. Other than that, we're good.
All right. Sandboxes?
Same thing. Chucks in and out. If they're sitting in the middle or if they're just blocking the way, I mean, if we're not on it, then like I said yesterday, y'all pull them in. Other than that, if you don't got to be back on the pad, don't be back there. If you have to be, have your PPE, and watch out for that forklift driver. Make sure he knows you're out there, and just keep up a good communication.
Marshall, we got for you.
Stay out of the swing area. If you have to come in the barrier or around the crane, let me know you're coming in before you just walk in. Observe your overhead loads. Pay attention to that man lift. Don't walk underneath that extended arm. And don't walk underneath the guns and the lubricator. Stay out of that area.
How many people give you directions one time?
12.
Works out good, doesn't it?
Absolutely.
All right.
Just one guy.
All right. Max, you got 4 sticks.
Yeah. All right. Muster is going to be in the front location. Secondary is going to be the opposite corner. Chase emergency, Chase, and our safety. Matt's going to be our driver. There's directions on the board. Closest hospital is going to be Lindsay. If it's a major emergency, we'll go to Chickasha. Like I said earlier, heat might be a factor today, so just stay hydrated. We are getting close to the end of this bad, so what we start doing now, picking up trash, cleaning up our areas, looking around, kind of let's get the little stuff down now, that way it's not a big problem at the end. So let's just all be our brother's keepers today, and just have a great day.
It's number one goal today. Everybody goes home safe and be a good day, huh? All right.
Heavenly Father, thanks for the grace today. Allow us to come to work and keep you safe this morning. We ask you to do the night cruise that they head in and get some rest and relaxation. Lord, collectively as a group, we thank you for the healing that you provided thus far for Eric's daughter, and we ask for your continued presence, continued healing so that she can get to the point and go home and fully recover, and that family can go back to life as normal as they know it. We thank you for the healing and the protection you allow for Dale and his family. We ask that you look over each and every one of us as we go about doing our different tasks on this path and keeping our mind and task at hand. And we ask that you help us mind our tongues as we get hotter, our tempers tend to flare up. We ask that you help us mind our tongues and watch what we say to each other. We ask for your shield of protection around the U.S. military that deployed around the world. We ask for your continued presence with family members of the Marines and the sailor that lost their lives a couple weeks ago. In your heavenly name, we pray. Amen. Amen.
I said AJ, not Matt.
Well, if Matt
seems like good old days.